and the Canucks get a hold of it. Steve Bernier gets out to center ice. Backhand shot at the open net, missed it.
What a great play by Bernier to fight through that traffic, get over the red line, and not ice the puck.
Mason Raymond quickly after a loose puck, hit the post! And the Leafs still have life thanks to that. Ponikarowski turned it over. Burrows missed the net. There's the third chance at the open goal. Ryan Kessler on the puck. Leafs got to get up the ice in a hurry. Ponikarowski, Lee Stempniak, Hagman's with him, through the puck at the net. Big rebound, cleared away by Willie Mitchell to center ice, and that might do it. Kaberle, Ponikarowski, Edler to Mitchell, safely to center. Burrows for the open net on another post. Mason Raymond gets to the puck and puts it in. And a fitting end, perhaps Vancouver's best player on the night, Mason Raymond, gets his second and seals the deal 3-1.
Well, what I like so much about this play for the Canucks is never die. I mean, this line continued to put pressure on. The forecheck up ice by Kessler, by Raymond, and by Burrows earlier. And Raymond had his opportunity just before that and right off the post. A valiant third period effort by the Toronto Maple Leafs on the road. They dominated territorially, but once again are unable to get that big goal to give them a chance to win.
Might have been the Leafs' best game this season, but they now have officially had the worst start in team history.
Well, Roberto Luongo does what he did best. He shut the door and his team followed in front of him.
Too much speed in the second line. Raymond Mason. And of course, great game by Kessler. Radmer, wonderful performance by the Vancouver Canucks. And a great performance, like you mentioned, Simmer, from the goaltender who's the best in the world, Roberto Luongo.
But an entertaining night. Seldom a disappointment when these two teams meet in Vancouver.